10 real-life cyborgs at this moment. A cyborg is a human-machine hybrid. By this concept, everybody who wears contact lenses is a cyborg. In today's tech-driven culture, that kind of human-machine hybrid is irrelevant. Too many fantastic cyborgs from science fiction. RoboCop, Darth Vader, Inspector Gadget, and even the Borg from Star Trek. A convincing cyborg is more than a schmuck with Google Glass who can search up Starbucks locations while riding his hoverboard. Some outstanding real-life cyborgs are currently among us. Here are 10 real-life cyborgs at this moment. So, let's start. Number 10, the world's first bionic man, Jesse Sullivan. Perhaps the world's first bionic man. In 2001, while working as a lineman, Soldan was accidentally shocked by about 7,000 volts. Doctors had to amputate both of his arms due to serious burns. The Rehabilitation Institute of Chicago, or RIC, has outfitted Solvent with myoelectric arms, in Solvent's case nerve terminals in his chest. His nerves grew into muscle. Now, when Solvent thinks about moving his arms, nerves force his chest muscles to move, and electrodes in the prosthetic react. Sullivan moves his arms in a way that mimics the body's natural limb movement. As research progresses, the arm's capacities improve. Number 9, cybernetic professor Kevin Warwick has turned himself into a cyborg. Become a walking cyborg. Professor Kevin Warwick, a pioneer in the field of cybernetics, has become a cyborg. Warwick's arm received a microchip transponder in 1998. Warwick was just given a topical anesthetic. The chip tracked his travels for weeks, allowing him to control lights, doors, and computers just by walking around the University of Reading campus. 2002, he had a more complex electronic system connected to nerve endings in his arm. Warwick now organizes Turing test events, operates appliances with his body, researches Parkinson's disease, and swoons self-described body hackers. Number 8. The iBorg Neil Harbison was born with extreme colorblindness. Colorblind persons can see color, but can't tell red from green and other colors. But Harbison only sees in black and white. In art school, he met tech genius Adam Montandon, who devised an inventive solution to his impairment. Harbison has a sensor in his skull that sees colors and transforms them to sound. Harbison can now hear 360 colors, or hues, since his camera ignores saturation. The initial iBorg, as Don and Harbison describe it, had cables coming out of his head and connecting to a laptop in a backpack. Harbison's latest iteration is a basic microprocessor under his skin at the back of his skull. The bright life isn't all roses. However, due to his head-mounted camera harvesting, he is frequently ejected from buildings. Number 7. Rob Spence lost his eye in a shooting accident when he was 9. He has lived with a typical fake eye for most of his life. Naturally, a filmmaker wished for a prosthetic with a camera. To attain this awesome aim, he assembled a tech-savvy team around an ocularist. Unlike Neil Harbison's cyborg, the camera is not linked to the brain. However, this iBorg allows others to perceive Spencer's perspective. A wireless transmitter in the camera feeds images to a portable monitor. The camera has flaws. It gets hot in Spence's skull, so he can only keep it for a few minutes. Number 6. Moon Rebus, the things people do for their art. In 23TN, Moon Rebus, a Spanish dancer, choreographer, and performance artist, had an earthquake sensor permanently implanted under her arm skin for a project called Seismic Sense. The sensor vibrates whenever an earthquake of at least 1 Richter occurs globally, and an app records the scale and location. In a more recent project, the artist and her audience await an earthquake. Rebus dances towards the direction of the quake, trying to convey its power. A light and music spectacle is created by her co-performer, cyborg Neil Harbison. Number 5. Ankle moves to his thoughts. Apocalyptic vistas and Björk volcanic mud spas are Iceland's contributions to the globe. Now the island nation offers natural prosthetic joints. The human body is so good at conveying brain impulses to its constituent parts that technology simply can't compete. Human leg joints can change for speed, terrain, and orientation so swiftly that people don't notice. A jointed prosthetic leg usually disappoints. Amputee, good marvel. Olafsson recently received a technological upgrade that made him cry. Iceland's officer recently received a new proprio foot prosthetic. Try walking without an ankle with this update. Hard. Number 4. Outfitted with own robotic arm. Claudia Mitchell lost her left arm in a motorcycle crash in 2004. She learned about research on a device that responds to brain signals. In 2006, the Marine veteran got her own arm, becoming the first female to get one. The Rehabilitation Institute of Chicago's prosthetic arm is attached to her body's nerve endings so she can move it like her other arm. Her bionic arm also provides her with touch. The prosthetic study is supported in part by DARPA, the agency rumored to be working on super soldiers. Mitchell is a musician for the Arkansas Symphony Orchestra. She continues to work on the bionic technology research team. Number 3. Argus 2. Anthony Andriotola was diagnosed with RPE in his 20s. 10 years later, he was blind. He restored his sight in October 2015, courtesy to Johns Hopkins Hospital and Second Sights. This gadget includes an electrode-loaded chip in the retina, a transmitter in the front of the eye, and a pair of camera-equipped spectacles. The cameras give data to the transmitter, which then sends it to the electrodes, which create images. He doesn't have 20/20 vision, but he can distinguish the color of his daughter's sweater, which he has never done before. Number 2. A self-proclaimed cyborg. Angel Gufria is a cyborg. As a child star of sophisticated prosthetic technologies, she was born without her right hand. Her first bionic arm came before she turned one. Her current prosthetic was designed by Steeper, a British innovative prosthetic manufacturer. It gives Gufria excellent hand control. She can also crack an egg. She's been in a lot of movies with missing limbs. She starred in Mockingjay Part 1 and 2. Number 1. The intriguing myoelectric arm, when life gives you lemons, make lemonade. James Young's left foot was cut in a London drain in 2012. His left arm was amputated as a result. His left arm is the masterpiece of his prosthesis. His myoelectric arm allows him to use his muscles to operate his fingers as well as his arm. It also has an alternative limb project arm that looks like Solid Snake's arm from Metal Gear Solid. She added a few other functions to the arm like Bluetooth, a timepiece, and a USB port for charging his phone. It also contains a built-in drone that Young can launch from his shoulder. What do you think of our video? Let me know in the comment section below. If you enjoy this video and want to hear from me again, be sure to hit that subscribe button before you go. Thanks for watching!